The government is considering to launch two pilot projects to promote methanol. The projects being planned to launch in Maharashtra and Assam will see running of a fleet of 10 buses each in both the states fueled by methanol. A top official told today in a group of ministers meeting headed by Road Minister Nitin Gadkari that the government plans to launch two pilot projects in Assam and Maharashtra, wherein it would operate a total of 20 Mercedes-Benz buses charged by methanol as a part of its efforts to promote alternative fuels. The Resolution Professional of Assam Company Limited has delayed the last date for submission of resolution plan for the declining company to 5th of July from 27th of June following request from Committee of Creditors. It was understood that the Committee of Creditors had a meeting on Monday as a new declaration has been discovered from ICICI Bank UK and a host of new suitors revealed interest in Assam Company Limited. Assam State Disaster Management Authority stated that over 68,000 people were affected by floods in Dhemaji, Lakhimpur, Biswanath, Kachar, Karimganj and Hailakandi district as against 71,058 people on Tuesday. Three more people lost their lives in flood occurrences in Assam, increasing the death number in the state to 31, even as the general flood situation improved slightly on Wednesday. In a major step towards development, BJP National President Amit Shah, along with industrialist Ratan Tata, recently designed the foundation stone of 19 cancer specialized centers across the state, which will increase the potential to firmly improve cancer care in the state and Northeast region on a whole. The health sector in the state of Assam is on up as various developmental projects to improve health care have been assured in the state. Inam ul Haq Mengnu, a 2012 batch IPS officer from Dragur village of Shopian district of Jammu Kashmir, has now been made the commanding officer of an Assam police commando battalion based at Mandakata near the city. Amid reports of his missing brother doubted to have joined the militant ranks in Jammu Kashmir, the Assam government on Wednesday transferred IPS officer Inam ul Haq from his present posting as superintendent of police of Hamrin in Assam's Karbi Anglong district. According to Kharupetia police in charge Chandan Goswami, a rumor about Xopa Dhora, that is a child lifter on the prowl, caused panic at Arimari village and the villagers caught Kusum Ali suspecting him to be a child lifter. But luckily the villagers informed the police rather than taking any action on their own, which resulted in saving an innocent life. The awareness drive started in Assam following the recent lynching of two youths in Karbi Anglong, guessing them to be child lifters, has brought in a positive result in Darang district when villagers, instead of taking the law into their own hands, handed over a suspected child lifter to police on Tuesday night. One of the pamphlets for the awareness meetings read, "Do not believe in rumor or fake news. The applicants who do not find their names in the complete draft of NRC will get another opportunity by way of submission of claims and objections for inclusion in final NRC. An opportunity will also be given to file objections against inclusion of any ineligible person. In case of any confusion or queries, please visit your NRC Seva Kendra or call the helpline numbers given below." The executives of the National Registrar of Citizens Coordinator has made a community awareness drive across Assam to curb the possibility of law and order problems, fearing that fake news or rumors could lead to haphazards during publication of complete draft of NRC 1951. A report by Harsh Mandir, who resigned as Special Monitor for Minorities of NHRC 2 days back, highlights the plight of the so-called foreigners in detention centers of Assam. The report stated that in Golpara, out of total 62 convicted foreign nationals, 54 are from Bangladesh, including 4 Hindus. All 54 Bangladeshi nationals have completed their terms of punishment and all want to go back to their countries. But they don't have any contact with their family members in Bangladesh. Most of their families even don't know that they are detained in Indian detention center. One Muslim woman is from Myanmar. She told that she is married to an Assamese Muslim and had a child from him. Both mother and child were detained. Her husband visited her for some time but then stopped. She doesn't have any communication with her family in Myanmar now. In the end of his report, Harsh Mandir has made some important recommendations to the government, which include establishing and following provisions of international law and Article 21, do not separate families, ensure due process, ensure policies for early deportation, repatriation of farmers who don't contest, apply juvenile justice laws, special care of patients with mental health issues and older patients. Detention should be the last resort and cannot be indefinite, clarifying respective jurisdiction of foreigners, tribunals and NHC. Mandir was forced to make the report public. Abhijit Sharma of Assam Public Works, the petitioner in NRC case in Supreme Court, said that the apex court will take up the case on 2nd of July. After the administration responsible with producing the remaining draft of Assam's National Register of Citizens urged the Supreme Court pursuing more time than original 30th June publication deadline because of floods in the water-sided state. Taesong said that the give and take policy would be again talked about once the meeting between the two chief ministers of both states is held. Taesong said that he personally felt that the spirit of give and take should be there. If it is not there, the door is closed. If the door is closed, then there is no point of meeting. Meghalaya Deputy Chief Minister Preston Taesong created the idea of transforming interstate boundary squabble between Meghalaya and Assam through a give and take policy.